Ravana. Every child in India knows the story of Ramayana, and we all know Rama, Sita, the four brothers of Rama, the story of Dasharath. We know the entire history and we know the good and the bad. As a child, you are taught very clearly about what is good, what is bad. So in your minds, it's very clear Rama is good and Ravana is bad. Now, but as you start exploring these great stories and epics, obviously they are great stories and epics not because they are such simple stories. There is a lot more layers to it. But we tend to take the easier way out. But when you start exploring the characters of Ramayana, if Rama is a very, very key character in Ramayana and Sita is a very key character in Ramayana, another character which is even more important is Ravana. But the story has always been from the victor's point of view. Every story in the world is always from the winner's point of view. Nobody likes to listen to the story from the loser's point of view. That is why when you go through the mind of Ravana and find out what is his thought process, why did he do what he did? If you take any court case, anything, there are always two sides to an argument, right? And then finally we judge based on circumstances, based on whatever the truth is at that point in time. But the idea is not to say you are right or you are wrong, but to understand the story from Ravana's mind. What is he going through? Of course, we all know what he did, but we all know only one of the things he did. Why did he do what he did? What is his mission in life? Why is he there in the story? Is it just to kidnap Sita and create Ramayana, or is there some more to this character called Ravana? Why has there been so much of description given about Ravana as a Rakshas, as a Brahmin, as a Vedic scholar, as a Shiva Bhakt? So there is a lot of layers to that which we don't tend to explore as much. So that is why this story is different, because we are looking at the mind voice of Ravana. At which point? At a point where everything is gone and going for him, including his own life, which he himself knows. Like most great scholars, he knows his life is coming to an end. And that is the point when most of us get into a reflective kind of a mode. And that's why we feel that this particular version on Ravana's last day is the most authentic mind of Ravana. And that's why this interpretation is probably different from many of the other stage interpretations. Very powerful. When I act like Ravana, I feel extremely powerful, because apart from the other faults and the other characteristics of Ravana, one thing which is very clear in the character, the way the play is written, is an extremely powerful. When I say powerful, I'm not talking about physical power, I'm talking about his mental power, his capacity. For a man who's so brilliant, such a scholar, why did he do something so obviously bad? So there is a lot of power inside Ravana in his heart, in what he feels right and what he thinks about what is right and wrong in the world. His statement is about what is right and wrong in the world. So that is what I find, the power of Ravana. Ravana has understood the world. He's a jnani. He's not just a rakshas. He's a Brahman jnani. So that is what I find different when I try this Ravana, because normally we think of Ravana as a very strong physical guy, you know. But Ravana is a characteristic. Ravana is a feeling. Ravana is a figment of a character of a person. So there is a Ravana in you, there's a Ravana in me, there's a Ram in you, there's a Ram in me. So what I'm trying to tell people is that Ravana, don't think of it as a physical entity. That physical entity is easy for visualization and for children. But you must realize the Ravana within you. So when I play Ravana, I feel very powerful. I don't feel bad. I don't feel evil. I find myself very powerful. And I sometimes feel very sad that a man who knows so much, maybe he didn't have the right counsel, maybe he didn't have the right kind of intelligent people around him. Lots of great leaders in the world have been lost because of the counsel they keep. So that's exactly probably what happened to Ravan. The most intelligent person in Ravan's life was probably Vibhishan, and unfortunately he went away. So probably the rest of them were not as intelligent as Ravan for them to advise Ravan. And probably a great soul, a great mind was lost to the world and known to the world as a villain only because he didn't keep the right company. So I feel very vulnerable, very powerful as Ravana.
When the audience is very less, really what do you feel?
Well, lots of times when an audience is less, how does an actor feel? I will tell you something. Most of our rehearsals, we have only one or two people watching us throughout the rehearsal. We do more rehearsals than number of shows. So we are all used to performing for one person, maybe the director, and maybe two or three people as part of the crew. So less audience is not a big deal for an actor. Obviously, every actor would like more and more people to come and watch. But what happens then? When you see only 10 people or 12 people, you must realize that for them, this is the first time they are doing the, we are doing the show. So, it's not their fault that the others did not come. So, you cannot reduce our intensity because they are less. In fact, you should give them an experience where they should say, "Cha, more people could have come." So, your level of, I think when the audiences become lower, the energy levels as an actor to wanting to reach out becomes higher because he knows there is only few of them and he has to keep them active. It becomes easier when there are a lot more people. So, that challenge is something which an actor will rise up to it and meet it. It is disappointing, but it also acts as a great boost for us to give something more than our best when the numbers are very less.
Om, Om Namo Bhagavate Rudraya, Namaste Rudra Manyava Utota Ishave Namaha, Namaste Astu Dhanvane Bahubhyamutate Namaha, Yata Ishu Shivatama Shivam Babhuvate Dhanuhu, Shivasha Rabhya Yata Vatayano Rudra Mridaya, Yate Rudra Shiva Thanura Khora Papakashini Tayanastanu Vashantamaya Girishanta Vichakashihi Yami Chung Girishanta Haste Viharshyastave Shiva Giritra Kurumahi Kumsi Purusham Jagat.
Ram, know me as I am, conqueror of heaven, hell, earth, vanquisher of gods and humans, Lanka's subjugator, supreme ruler, Ravan. Incomparable, superior to all humans, the mighty Ravana. And recognize yourself too. Look within, gauge who you are. Are you human or divine? If you are human, you cannot be divine. And if you are divine, you can hardly be human. If you are not human, the claim to be the best among humans, Purushottam, rings false, a mere pretense.
If you are God, then I alone am best among humans, with earth as our witness. Or else say, you are no God. Ram, this is our destiny. It's irony that you and I are arrows of history's common quiver. Two truths, two resolves, two entities. One human and the other God.
Pavana chastu ti patra, pavana chanitra, pavana chastu ti patra, pavana chanitra. Prabhu Sama.